Welcome to another video. This time we will make a review for my Duster after 3 years and 75,000 kilometers. First of all, I want to add that I'm very satisfied with this car, and I'm patiently waiting for the third generation in order to buy it. Yes, although I had some problems with the car during these 3 years, I can honestly say that overall I'm very satisfied, and I encourage you to go and make a drive test, watch some reviews, and find out more about this car if you are planning to buy one in the future. For any other questions, feel free to ask me in the comment section, and I will answer all your questions and explain any issues or things you want to know. Okay, I think this is the right place to make the review. Now I'm going to show you the exterior of the car, talk about some problems I had with the exterior, show you how the paint looks like, and some other things I think you will be interested in finding out. We're going to start with the back. In my opinion, the back looks rather okay. We lost the cap for the hook. I didn't bother to buy another one because at some point I think we would have lost it as well. Everything works okay. The pistons for lifting the trunk door were changed on the warranty. At some point, at around 74,000 kilometers. Besides that, everything looks okay. I removed the part that covers the trunk because I needed more space. I'm sorry for the mess I have in my car. I honestly didn't have time to clean it up a little bit. Yes, so in the back we have the rear view camera. The lights work very good. I didn't have any problems with the tail lights. No light bulbs were changed. So on the side you can see we have some scratches. All the surface from the sides you can see many scratches. Here on the back door, left door, we have a deep one. I don't know if it could go out with a polish. So the plastic covers for the doors are holding very good. I didn't have any problems. Also the plastic covers for the fender flares. Recently I've changed my shock absorbers. If you watch the video with the installation, I used one with 3.5 centimeters lift. Right now I'm using the winter tires, Riken SUV Snow, that are mounted on the 17 inch alloy wheels that I got when the Duster came from the factory. The wheels, in my opinion, are very worn out. There are some scratches, big scratches, no bends whatsoever. Even if I went in some pretty
hard off-road trails for these alloy wheels with rocks and mud. Coming up on the front side, here on the front side we made some pretty good modifications. I installed a winch a couple of months ago. If you want to see more details, if you want to see more details of that installation process, you have it on my channel. This winch is a very important upgrade. I used it a couple of times, and besides its main function, that is to help me when the car gets stuck, it also helps a lot protecting the radiators that are in the back. We have this massive steel box that is protecting the radiators. One downside of this setup, it can get lots of rocks and mud stuck in there, and if you don't get the front grille off, it is really hard to clean it up. So I made a nice adjustment under the number plate. Here is where I keep the winch hook. Another modification, I received these LED headlights from Oxpin. Of course, you can see it tested out on a separate video. They light up very good, and I'm very satisfied with it. As some of you may know, when I got the car, this part was gray, but on some off-road occasions we got it broken really bad. And when I decided to install the winch, I went and bought another front bumper, another part, which is black. Unfortunately, this part also got broken. We lost the cap on both sides, and at some point I think I will change this part and this part also. With the installation of the winch, the front of the car got a little heavier. You may observe that in some videos, but with the mounting of the new set of shock absorbers, I got the car lifted, and right now I can honestly say that it is a good improvement overall, especially in off-road conditions. That's about it for the exterior. Let's see if we have some premature wear signs on the outside. The only way, or the only places you can see those signs, are on the interior of the doors. Right here we can see that the paint is a little bit scratched, but if I remember well, at 50,000 kilometers I made another review and this looked exactly the same. At some point this contact will become, I don't know, usual, and these scratches won't get any deeper. I think the interior looks very good. I'm sorry for the mess. I will have to take the car and do a full interior detailing, but that will happen, I guess, when I will decide to sell it. I didn't make many changes for the interior. I only changed the nav system, but we will talk about the new nav system I have on a separate video. And I bought these rubber pads. I think they are very good because they have this high edge that keeps the water in. One downside of these pads, they are kind of slim, and especially the ones on the back, move a lot. The part from the driver's position has two locking points, and at least this one is very steel. Now let's go on and see how the engine sounds like after 75,000 kilometers. In fact, there are almost 77,000 kilometers. Let's see, we have a consumption of 5.9 liters. And let's see how the engine sounds like. The pistons are working very okay. I think I hear a rattling noise. It might come from the timing belt, I don't know. In 3 years I haven't added any water or cooling liquid, and I also never washed the engine. As you can see, here we have the headlights, the wires go somewhere around here. The battery is the one that came from the factory. Let's see how the air filter looks like. Looks like after 5,000 kilometers, I guess. I don't know. Oh, that's not good. How the hell did you end up in here? What do you think about the air filter? I will change it tomorrow. I have to go to the dealership service. Besides that, I think the engine looks okay. As some of you may know, I had some problems with the timing belt. It was changed on the warranty. Also, on the warranty, I changed the all the parts that go from the gear changer into the gearbox. Besides the problems I had with the timing belt and the gear changer, I also had some problems with the rear differential. That was before I changed the clutch. Yes, at 70,000 kilometers I also changed the clutch. It was my mistake because I forced it very hard and it got burnt. The whole replacement process was about 800 euros, parts and labor included. And before I replaced the clutch, I had some problems with the rear differential. At some point it overheated and I couldn't use it anymore. From what I saw from other colleagues from the Facebook group Dacia Duster Trails, the main problem would be using the Duster in auto mode for a very long time, then switch it to four-wheel drive lock mode, no matter how the ESC works or what mode do you use the ESC. Basically, if you go in auto mode with the ESC on or off, the clutches from the coupling of the Haldex system are forced too much
and the result is overheating, which makes the rear differential unusable. After I changed the clutch, I didn't have this problem anymore, but I can honestly say we went on easier trails and we didn't force the car that much. Once or twice I felt some smell coming from the clutch, but it was not that bad. So I don't know what to tell you more about the car. If you have any other questions, feel free to ask me. I will do a separate video to show you all the investments I made in the car, with the maintenance check, with the winch, the clutch, and any other accessories or parts I've bought in 3 years. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. It will help me a lot. Thank you.